Welcome back students to the virtual lab demonstration. This video demonstrates detection of acidic radicals. The links for the other experiment is provided at the end of this video and also in the description box. To get the notification of next video, please subscribe and like the video. I am Dr. Sujata Kasabe from ABASAHEB GARWARE College, Pune. Let us see the detection of acidic radicals. Acidic radicals like CO3 2- S2- PO4 3- BO3 3- are easily detected during the dry test for anions. Halides and nitrates may also be detected in dry tests if the tests for them are carried out carefully. Let us prepare the solution for the detection of acidic radicals. For the preparation of solution, always use distilled water. Take clean and dry test tube. Take small portion of mixture. To that, add distilled water. After addition of distilled water, shake this mixture well. Now, if the mixture is water soluble, then use this solution directly for the detection of acidic radicals. But if this mixture is not soluble in water, then this mixture is water insoluble. Now we have to prepare sodium carbonate extract, and by using this sodium carbonate extract, again we have to prepare neutral extract. Let us see the procedure for the preparation of sodium carbonate extract. For that, take 0.1 gram of mixture and then add 0.2 gram of sodium carbonate. To this, add 10 ml distilled water and boil this solution well. After boiling this solution, cool it well and then filter the solution through ordinary filter paper. This is sodium carbonate extract. Next step is the preparation of neutral extract. To prepare neutral extract, take small portion of this sodium carbonate extract and to that add CH3COOH till it become acidic. Then boil it well, and now this is our neutral extract solution. So we have to use sodium carbonate extract or neutral extract or water solution for the detection of acidic radicals. So the first test for the detection of acidic radical is addition of AgNO3 in neutral extract or in water solution. Then observe whether Cl-, Br-, I-, PO4-3- or BO3-3- is present. So for the detection of these radicals, let us begin the test. Take neutral extract or water solution. To this solution, add AgNO3 dropwise. After addition of this AgNO3, shake this solution well. If curdy white precipitate is obtained, then to this curdy white PPT, add dilute HNO3 dropwise. Shake it well. It is insoluble. Now to the same solution, add NH4OH dropwise. It is soluble. It means that Cl- is present in the mixture. Next observation for the AgNO3 addition. After the addition of AgNO3, dropwise. Shake it well. If pale yellow PPT is observed, then to this PPT, add ammonia solution dropwise. Shake it well. It is soluble, so Br- is present. Next observation for the addition of HNO3 solution to the neutral extract or water solution is, shake it well, yellow PPT is observed here. So to this yellow PPT, add dilute HNO3 solution drop wise, shake it well, it is insoluble. To the same solution, add NH4OH solution drop wise, it is insoluble again in NH4OH solution, I minus is present. Next test for the addition of HNO3 solution, shake it well, yellow PPT is observed. Then to this yellow PPT, add dilute HNO3 drop wise. After the addition of dilute HNO3, shake it well, it is soluble in dilute HNO3, so PO43 minus is present. So the last test for the addition of HNO3 in neutral extract or in water solution, add drop wise HNO3 solution, shake it well, so white PPT is observed. To this white PPT, add dilute HNO3 drop wise, shake it well. After shaking, if the PPT is soluble, then BO3 minus is present. So this is test 1 for the detection of Cl minus, Br minus, I minus, PO43 minus, BO33 minus. So let us see test 2. It is for the detection of SO42 minus radical. For that, take neutral extract or water solution. To this solution, add BaNO3 drop wise and shake it well. If white PPT is observed, then add dilute HNO3 drop wise. Shake it well, it is insoluble, so SO42 minus is present and confirmed. Next test is test 3 for the detection of S2 minus radical. For that, take sodium carbonate extract. To this sodium carbonate extract, add lead acetate drop wise and then shake it well. If black PPT is observed, then to this black PPT, add HNO3 drop wise. Shake it well. It is soluble in HNO3, so S2 minus is present and confirmed. Next test is test number 4 for the detection of NO2 minus. For that, use sodium carbonate extract or water solution. To this solution, add dilute acetic acid drop wise and then shake it well. After shaking, to this solution, now add freshly prepared FeSO4 solution drop wise. Shake it well. If brown colored solution is observed, then NO2 minus is present and confirmed. Test number 5 is for the detection of NO3 minus. For that, take sodium carbonate extract or water solution. To this solution, add concentrated HNO3 drop wise and shake this solution well. After the addition of concentrated HNO3, place this test tube with solution in a water containing beaker for cooling. Then to this solution, add freshly prepared FeSO4 solution drop wise from the side of the test tube. brown ring will develop at the junction of these two solution. So this is the test for NO3-. So NO3- is present and confirmed over here. Next test is for the detection of CO3-. For that, take small quantity of mixture in a test tube and to this mixture add dilute HNO3 drop wise. If brisk effervescence are observed in the solution, then CO3-- is present and confirmed. So these are the tests for the detection of acidic radicals. Thank you students for watching this video. Please subscribe and like the video.